Today's bow hunt will hopefully give you an inside look at what I believe to be the most enjoyable and ethical means of turkey hunting, head shooting gobblers. Today I'll take 9 lives, and hopefully not only will you enjoy the show, leave knowing a bit more about a challenging means of bringing home the bird. And trust me, it's not easy. For one thing, they need to be close, as in really close. To me, it's often the end result, but it's more about the thrill of the chase. But when it all comes together, well, the kill is just a bonus. And today's a bonus show for you. Four big toms are en route to my decoy. They're well within gun range. 8 more yards will put them close enough for a good old neck slocking.
I should have brought 2 tags today because they kept hanging around. That was a pretty awesome set.
Now, before we get too far into this, no one said it would be easy. And you better leave your shotgun at home. Otherwise, you're liable to throw your bow in the back of the blind and start blasting. Because when your heart's pounding, it sure is hard to hit them in the head. How could I miss these 3? They're basically lined up like cordwood. You're basically aiming at a golf ball, set atop a pencil. If you can hit the ball or the pencil, you're gonna score. But a little left or a little right, and, well, you usually just get feathers. So, anyway, Perry and I have been turkey hunting here for a couple days, having a great time here in Kansas, and this big bird laying here, well, Perry filmed it, and I slocked it.
My first time filming.
Yeah. So let's take a look and see how well Perry did. The big old Tom, he comes strutting right into us, didn't he?
Yes, he did. It's awesome.
Yeah. But this is a good spot, and this is kind of how it all went down. Hopefully it's not too shaky, because Perry was filming for the first time. If a bird's in full strut, it's really hard to lop his head off or break his neck. For the broadhead grabs too many feathers before it reaches your vital target. So yelp at the bird, and 9 out of 10 times, he'll turn and face the music. Big old bird, huh, Perry?
Beauty.
Sure is exciting when they get about 4 feet away from you. You shoot them right in the head. That's awesome.
Gobblers and jakes. They hang together throughout the winter. But come spring, they don't like each other. This old Tom wanted nothing to do with my decoy. But when he realized that Jake was about to get some action, well, the rest is nothing but a sad story for the old lovesick Tom.
Beard on that bird. Holy cow. He got slocked right in the neck. Bit him in. Didn't cut his head off, but definitely killed him.
I couldn't get this guy to face me, so it required a surgical headshot. There's nothing more intense than to have a flock of big toms 5 yards outside the window. Stretching their necks out and posturing. They're looking for a rival tom, or perhaps cautious of my unfamiliar decoy. Either way, you have to hold still and be patient, because they're picking the place apart. And there's several eyes doing it. Bow hunting takes patience, but eventually, they will stop where you can get a shot. And either way, a stretched out neck is never a good idea when you're around these parts. Looking at this clip, you know it ain't gonna be good for the old Tom.
He's locked these ass.
Tim's new. I don't know what they're gonna call it, but Tim's new
prototype.
Yeah, prototype. We've been sitting here all morning, haven't hardly seen anything, sitting here just talking, having a good time. Five gobblers coming from the right, and six yards maybe. Looked like it took the head off, so it works.
shot his head right off. The blades actually hit him in the head and chopped the head right off. That's a quick clean.
Spear hunting turkeys? Well, it hasn't worked out for me yet. But hey, I gotta try. And rabbits? Well, they're not so easy either. I like to draw my birds within 10 yards of my blind, but I prefer 5. Of course, this means a lot of birds that you would easily kill with your shotgun are probably going to get away.
Well, it's been a good hunt, and that shows you, if you just give it a little time, a little bit of patience, sometimes you can get a shot. Haven't seen any turkeys in the last 3 days, and then the next thing you know, I'm tagged out. And I'm not too picky. Yeah, they're jakes, but any turkey's a good turkey to me, especially when I'm just shooting at their heads. And they come walking in, tiptoeing in, and saw the dead bird on the ground. He kind of stuck his head out there, looked around, and schlock. This is fun stuff. You know, I like to shoot at the head on a turkey because if you hit them in the head or in the neck, they're dead instantly. But if you miss, they're not wounded or nothing. And those birds are laying right where they stood when I let the arrow rip.
They came into the decoys just perfectly, and I got to try the new Oneida bow out on them. You need an accurate bow and an accurate broadhead. And I had both today. Man, it cleaned their clock when they came in there. First one's looking at my decoy. I took my time. I waited till he got his head sticking out there, and I was like, right there. And whop, he didn't even know what hit him. Boy, his body stood right in place and his head dropped on the ground.
I don't go anywhere without the old Slockmaster blowgun. When the turkey hunting's slow, there's always something to hunt. Frogs, rabbits, there's always something around to keep me busy. Got him! Now and again, you gotta let the cameraman have a shot. It keeps Haji interested. Lord knows he'll never hit one and steal my glory anyhow. This 2-year-old Rio is afraid of my Jake decoy. That's why he's hanging up. He wants to do it, but wisely can't bring himself to come on in. He continues to strut back and forth. He's kind of smart. Yep, he just spotted Haji drawing his bow. But now he's stretching out his long neck. Not a good idea. By golly, Haji, you have scored.
That took his head off. Woo! Just about got her off, Tim. Close though. Nice beer run. Woo!
Unfortunately, my broadheads sometimes leave a mark, and if you're hoping to mount your next big tom, I'd go with my competition's broadhead instead. Well, there you go. No tracking required. I figured there wasn't enough action in this short film I've made you, so I leave you with a wing shot slocking banana. Locked in.
Good shot, Tim.